Hello there! In this video, we're going to show you how to paint the red scales of Cthorak, Ionus Cryptborn's Draconith. We're painting these scales in the exact way that Warhammer Plus's army painters did for Battle Report. If you want to see how to paint scales to the next level, make sure to go check out Citadel Color Masterclass, where Ed will show you how to do that. The paints we'll be using are on the screen now. We also have a list of the additional equipment we've used, but you can use whatever brushes you feel most comfortable with. If you're new to painting or want to brush up on your skills, you can check out the Citadel Color Painting Essentials videos to learn all about our paints and painting techniques. We've undercoated our model with grey sear to give us a nice base coat to work from. Right, let's get painting. We're going to dive straight in and do all the scales on the main body and wings. For this, we'll be using Flesh Terrors Red straight from the pot and applying it with an STC medium shade brush. When applying contrast over a large model like this, it's best to do it in sections. Focus on getting that section completely covered in the contrast before moving to the next. This will help to get good coverage as well as removing any excess pooling while it's still wet and therefore avoiding unwanted texturing or staining. If we look at the box art, we can see that the underbelly is a different shade to the main scales. Therefore, make sure not to paint there. A good tip is to map out where you want your contrast paint to go before applying it in full near the underbelly scales. You can see how we're just dragging our brush as a line to help us out with where the two different tones will be. Once we're finished with the torso, we're just going to paint the wings as well. With the Flesh Terrors Red applied, we're well on our way with this project. We're now going to add our first highlight to the scales. We'll be dry brushing Wild Rider Red over all of the red using an STC medium dry brush. Get a load of Wild Rider Red onto your paintbrush and work off most of the paint onto a paper towel, working the remaining pigment into your brush's bristles. Once that is done, gently brush over the scales. The paint will naturally pick out all of the raised details. This method worked very well for scales in particular because of the multiple edges and grooves in the scales. If you want to know more about dry brushing, you can always go check out our Painting Essentials videos about dry brushing. With that first dry brush complete, we now need to do a second brighter layer. For our second highlight, we'll be lightly dry brushing Lugganath Orange. Make your way around the torso and wings, aiming to pick out the most prominent and raised scales. This will create a nice multi-tone effect for the previous layer and the Flesh Terrors Red base layer underneath. With that step complete, our scales are now done. We now need to pick out the underbelly. We need to re-layer the grey sear base coat to set ourselves up for doing the underbelly. So we're going to use a small base brush to carefully paint over any red overspill that we can find. Take your time doing this step. If you do make a mistake, go back over the previous red layers to fix it. We'll probably need to do a few layers here to get a nice strong base coat established again as well. So just make sure to thin your paint and wait until the first layer is dry before adding any more in order to avoid unwanted texturing. Okay, with the base coat established, let's crack on with doing the rest of the colors. For the underbelly, we want to just give the skin a slight hint of purple color, so we'll be using contrast medium in a 3:1 ratio with Magos Purple and applying it all over the area. As always with contrast paint, try and do it in sections so we can give ourselves enough time to soak up any excess to stop pooling or tide marks. If you get some Magos Purple on the red scales, don't worry, because in this instance, it will just blend the two areas of the scales and the underbelly together nicely. With that complete, we just have our final stage to do. For our final paint, we'll be dry brushing Deepkin Flesh with a small dry brush over the raised areas of the underbelly. Gently pick out these areas, but don't worry too much if you get some of the paint on the red scales near the pale skin areas. This will help to blend the two areas together and make it look natural. With that highlight complete, the pale underbelly skin is fully painted. And there we go. The red scales for Cthorak are complete. This is a nice and simple way to tackle painting Cthorak and get him on the gaming table in no time at all. The army painters really are geniuses. For more tutorials, tips, and tricks, check out our videos on the Warhammer YouTube channel or head to your local Warhammer store where our amazing staff will be more than happy to help. Well, we hope you've enjoyed this video and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye!